What's up, everybody? It's been the movie X Kicks, and as you can see, I have here what they're calling Sneaker of the Year. The review of the Nike LD Waffle Sakai is coming up right after this. It is already only in March, and they are talking about Sneaker of the Year hype already. And this Nike LD waffle is what they're calling it. The waffle actually is a hybrid. This shoe is actually a hybrid shoe, which is but it comes originally from these maker called Sakai, who is a Japanese brand in Japan, obviously. They actually just debuted this shoe and a couple months ago at their fashion week in Paris, and the internet went kind of crazy over it. And they did release these shoes on Sakai's website, and they pretty much sold out immediately. But since then, they actually had a March 7th release date, but after that, we heard nothing. It's safe to say we're well almost at the end of March, and there is still no release date for these. Now, like I said, it was only in select retailers, pretty much all the way overseas, mostly in Japan and Europe, but none in America, or really, there's no official release date for these shoes just yet. So, I'm gonna break down more about this shoe, and I'm gonna tell you a little bit about the resale prices and how these are going. But first, if we get into these, we get this nice little orange box. I love slide-out boxes like this. You hit it with, you get the with the Nike orange at the top, and I love how the Nike just comes around. I just like orange box, and then also you get a nice little Sakai and Nike banner, if you will. So I just thought that was a nice little touch, and thank you for the people at StockX. As you can see, it's StockX certified as being 100% authentic. Not that there's really a lot of fake things going around just yet, but bet you're sure there will be a lot. Let's put that up right there. Now, as we get into this bad boy, it also does come with an extra pair of laces, white. Now, this shoe is I kind of got, I'm not gonna lie, I bought into the hype. Like, I thought the shoe was just kind of okay. Now they're calling this like Sneaker of the Year already, but I still think the Travis Scott to me is personally the Sneaker of the Year. That's just my personal opinion. We
But
first saw Sakai, Nike sneaker in a Japanese fashion show Paris Week. As I said, the brand released the LVD Waffle Daybreak on their own website. So, hey, what's up, buddy? I'm doing a review right now. Can you just give me a little bit of space? Thank you. Thank you. Bullet, back up. Back up. Back up. Go sit, Bullet. Go sit. Sorry, it's my dog. However, as of today, the wider release has been canceled, as the latest in Europe retailers have removed the raffle and communications from all their Instagrams and also social media sites. So that sucks. Wow. So the sneaker is a hybrid of Nike's LDV and Waffle Daybreak, which so I'm not for sure about what the LDV and Daybreak waffles are. I haven't seen those shoes. I'm gonna do a couple of research, and I'm gonna probably drop a picture down for you after I do a little research. But let's get into this actual shoe, and let's show like the finer details of maybe why everyone kind of going crazy over these shoes. As I get into this shoe, you'll see that the first thing that you kind of notice about this shoe is everything is doubled up. Everything in this shoe is double checks, double laces, double tongues, and I think a lot of reason why people are kind of, hyped around this shoe, because we've never really seen a shoe that kind of double up like this shoe has particularly has. So, like I said, as I get to the tip of the tongue of this,
You
as
have
we get into the tongue, we get the two tongues, which is the first one has the orange Nike check, and if you peel it back, the second tongue has the Nike and the black check with Sakai going across the middle of it. And then as we go into the side of it, now this is one thing you can't notice in this shoe, like in pictures and stuff, and you have to kind of, like I said, get that in person. But this actually is a see-through. It is a mesh material throughout the mid part of the mid guard of the shoe. It's all mesh, so you can really see through this. I know kind of like through the pictures, I mean through the camera from this angle, you can't see, but close up it is a mesh and a see-through. I love how the leather comes on the Nike Check, and this one is not. Then the silver is not leather. The silver is almost like a, well, no, it is leather. I think, yeah, the silver is leather. The silver and the yellow are the yellow Checks. And then also with the top of the upper is a suede. So I just love how they mix and match of leather, mesh. Like, you wouldn't see that in almost 80% of the shoes are out. Like, you're not going to see people put all this, all these materials into one shoe. And I love the back. As you go into the back, it has just hit with the nice part of the more suede in the back of the toe. With the brand Nike Sakai, hit it with the nice little leather. As the as you can see, the silver comes around to the back and hits that nicely, just like that. And then one thing that I realized when I was when I saw this in pictures, I thought that this red was a like a red, but actually it's more of a burgundy red. Like when I got it in person, I was like, I thought that was, I like the fact that it's like a, I kind of might have liked it more of a red, but this, but the way this burgundy sits, it just, it pops off mighty nice. Like, I like this burgundy red. And, as we get down to the shoot, and like I said, the double laces, which is, to me, that's a crazy little style right there, because I've never seen a double lace shoe. Now, be cautious, guys. Like, these, they say they do run a little big. I generally wear a 10.5, but for these, I just went down and got a 10. And I almost thought I couldn't fit them at first because they come tied so tightly. So just make sure when you get them, just untie them and undo just one of the knots and one of the laces and pull them out, and then you'll be able to fit them just fine. Now, the retail price for this is only $155, but the hype on this shoe is already through the roof. Prices are literally ranging from $1,200 to almost $2,000. So, yeah, the hype on the shoe is just ridiculous, right? But the other thing I think a lot of people like about this shoe is the back of the heel. It's like an extended, like I said, everything on the shoe is, everything on the shoe is doubled up. So they even took the back of the shoe and made it extended to the longer part and made it, and just made it even longer. So it's just crazy, because this kind of remind me of, I don't know what the names are, but they have the Japanese shoes. They're kind of like wooden sandals almost, and like I think they're actually, the way they fit is kind of like that Japanese style. That's why I kind of got that elongated back. I think that's the look they were going for. I just got these actually like yesterday, and I've already worn them already out, and like people just kind of, they like, damn, like people just stop me and like, bruh, them shoes is hot. They just so different. So I mean, I guess we, you know, look at it from that aspect. I think that's another reason why people are calling the shoe of the year, because people love things that are different. You know, like this shoe stands out in a crowd. It's see-through mesh. It's got leather, suede, two tongues, two shoestrings, two Checks. I mean, it's just, everything is just so doubled up in the shoe, and it makes it stand out to all the other competition that's coming out. So and as you go to the, the bottom of the shoe, that's one thing I love about just this, another, just, I like just black toes, like, you know, stuff like this, because, you know, most shoes, they're coming white soles, and every shoe is going to get dirty when you wear it, but I just hate, like, you know, when you create a shoe and it has a white sole, and it's just dirty. And I think, like, the most standout thing about this shoe is these two little, I don't even know how to describe it, it's like two little, rubber blocks in the very tip of the shoe, kind of like a little stab, like, you know, if you kick someone with this, it probably would hurt. So I'm not for sure exactly what the significance of that is, but I like it. It's different, it stands out, you know, like I said. And also, as you go to the side, you'll see the midsole is a white, it's almost like a creamy white. It's not like a white, but it's a nice kind of cream white, if you will. I mean, this only thing I don't like about this is that white that they put in here, because this is the type of white that gets dirty easily. But, so this is what they're calling, like I said, early front runner for shoe of the year. drop me some comments, guys. Tell me, guys, what you guys think of these Sakai Nike LD waffles. Do you think these are shoe of the year? Or do you think they're just overhyped and overpriced? Tell me what you guys think. Drop me some comments. Let me know what you guys think. As always, Mr. Movie X is out. Please subscribe. And also, as usual, I'm about to shoot some on feet for you guys so you can see these babies in motion.
La música de Harry Fraud.